Seonjin. So, one, two. Yeah. This Seonjin is one, two. I'll do that. One, two. So it's one, one, two. So it folds naturally, yes? So as he's punching, assuming I could catch the arm, I'm more likely to catch it as he's pulling back. One, two, three. Right? Now this is low, but it doesn't need to be. Right? So I'm simply controlling moving with him. One, two. Yeah? One, two. I'm sticking with him. And that turn sticks with one, two. One, two. And you can see if he's doing a 1-2 punch, if I can pull him as he's moving back, even grab his clothes, taking the bite out of that completely. Yes? So that's just to show you what this does is it spins around. What's the problem with that? And that is his hand may not stay there. I want you to block me and grab, turn over. So back, yeah, grab my jacket, yeah. What if I didn't stay on that side? What if I would? This is called indirect fist. He deflects me. Yeah? Hold the other hand. So the moment I feel the deflection, I move around. And I can do it in pretty much any deflect somewhere else on object. Yeah? One, two. Here's the problem. One, two. So one, and now with Seisan, it doesn't go one, two, it goes one, two. And many people have said it's this. One, two. Now why you would circle around the arm, I don't know. But I have a fairly good idea that it might actually go that way because he's gone underneath. So when he punches, one, two. All I need to do is come straight down. One, two. One, two. Yeah? Punches, one, two. Same side.
Just goes straight up from underneath and then he grabs.
Accurate man.
And he seems to get a really good grip, but.
Yeah, well, some people can, and all credit to him. But honestly, I don't think I would risk anything using the palm. So I'm going to use the forearm. And now I have that. So they are taking one, two, one, two. So one, two, punches, one, two. Okay. And there you have why this one circles around that way. We're moving forwards and letting the left be with the left, the right, my left side deal with my left side, my right side deal with my right side. Seonjin would not work with an indirect fist. Okay, this would happen. Okay, instead, there, and I'm controlling the shoulder in both cases. They say this comes from Shimi, and you can see why. It's attacking the shoulder.
Would it work against someone who's much taller if they were attacking?
Let's try.
So you might not get the shoulder, but you'll control the elbow.
Yeah.
Bicep. Upper arm. It's still just getting an upper arm.
And that's also Shimi.
Jamaica's is still a big target.
Okay. One. Two. And that circular punch we did the block we did the other day. One, two, three, four. And it may be an extra punch. So this is slowly. I don't need to stop that shoulder. This is one of the curious things about this form. And this concept is I just stop the chest. Mm. And he could have a full blown, and I just stop the center of his chest, it's fine. Now he's going to be coming with the other hand. This hand is sort of in the way, so you can see he's going to be aiming high, which is great, because now I can skim right across the shoulder, which is why this one reaches, yeah? This one reaches, so 1, 2, 3, 4, I'm going. Okay, once again. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. You really gotta skim that. Let this off. And you got the last part of that movement. Yeah, so run this. Here's a punch there. And I just drop it. And you notice I don't need to slam it, I just need to slide it. And I tighten it to make it round edge, otherwise it's bone on bone. And that's why I do that. So full sequence is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Okay.
Back to there, buddy. Bang, bang, as well.